Hey guys, Brandon here from Rogue Fabrication. We're doing something interesting today. We're bending hex aluminum tubing on our new, brand new product, hex dies. You can see them in the link below, and it's pretty cool. And we're gonna show you how to do it, and we're gonna go over annealing aluminum. So what is annealing? Annealing is heating up a piece of metal and or glass and letting it cool, allowing it to relax and take stress out of it so that it's easier to manipulate.
Okay guys, so we are bending this 1¼ inch hex aluminum tube. This is our new 1¼ inch hex die. It does bend it on the flat. It does not bend it on the actual corners, but it bends on the flats. We are laying this out to do a bend. This material actually likes to crack under bending, so we're gonna put the clamp block on, measure off our 6-inch offset because we're on a 6 CLR, and then we're gonna do about 9.5 inches because we're doing a 90 degree bend and it takes up 105 thou per degree of bend. So 6 inches. Lines on here. These lines are going to let us know that we got the material hot enough in the annealing process. Since this stuff likes to crack, we are going to anneal it to soften it. Just put enough lines that you know you got it fully heated up. Alright, so that's our section. And we're going to use the oxyacetylene torch to do this. Gonna slowly heat up the whole area that's marked with Sharpie. And as it gets hot, you'll see the Sharpie start to fade. All right, all the lines have disappeared. Now we're gonna let it cool back down to room temperature and then we'll bend it. Okay guys, now that the part has cooled down, you can touch it again. Still a little warm. We're gonna bend this piece. As you might have noticed in the video, we had a little bit of torch malfunction, got some soot on it, and burning the soot off, we got it a little bit hotter than I wanted to in the middle. We're still gonna bend it and show you guys what happens when you accidentally overheat it. Set zero. We're gonna go at 90 degrees. There you go. Get in, pull it all the way out. You see, bent it very nicely.
All right. It's been 24 hours. We let this anneal tube sit and let its grain structure go back to normal. Now we're gonna put it back in the bender and show you what happens. Ugh. Make sure the clamp block's nice and tight. You can see here, these are all of our lines from where we annealed it. So that's where we're gonna be bending it. So as you can tell from our slow-mo shot, it did not crack. This was a little bit of a surprise to us, but this is what experimenting is for. So it seems like when you anneal the tube, some of those effects are longer lasting than we anticipated. So that gives you a larger window to bend your tube. We're gonna finish bending this to 90 degrees and see if it makes it all the way there. Looks really good. No cracks. Interesting results. Okay, so let's talk about our results. This one we slightly overheated, got a little bit too hot. You can kind of tell it has a little bit of hazing in the metal. It's still bent fine and actually looks really, really good. This one we did like basically how we would recommend you doing it, and it came out perfect. This one we heated up and then we let it sit. We were supposed to only let it sit for a day, but time got away from us and we let it sit for maybe a little over three weeks. And then we went to bend it and we were expecting it to break. We were expecting the stress to go back into the material, but it didn't. Interesting results, really good results though. It gives you a bigger window to work with your material. Now, since we got those results, we're gonna take this piece because we only annealed it from here to here. And we're gonna put it in the machine and we're gonna do an S-bend and we're gonna start bending this part and we're gonna see where the annealing heat zone stopped and it should break because this is unannealed. Let's do it. Okay, so that concludes our video for today. Like, comment, and subscribe. Stay tuned. We have a bunch of really cool videos coming out soon, and we'll see you on the next one. I found a room temperature, and then we'll bend it. F*** that torch.